Record. Left, 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 up. Alright, welcome back to Steven's Sausage Roll. Yeah, last episode was actually a little bit short. I'm kind of trying to shoot for 30 to 40 minute episodes for this one. Trying not to let them get too long, of course. Just trying to experiment with a shorter format when these puzzles are more self-contained. Although I'm sure as they get harder in later areas, it might take me like 30 or 40 minutes just to solve one puzzle. Or perhaps even longer than that, I might spend 2 or 3 episodes on one puzzle. But that's in the future. Right now we are still very much in the early game, and it is still possible to get multiple puzzles done in one video. This is still being recorded in the same session as parts 1 through 3, by the way. This is still March 22nd. So, back to the two puzzles that stumped me the first time I ran into them. Now I might be a little bit better equipped with reasoning skills to handle them, though. And we can eat 3 sausages at once, perhaps. Okay, so there is actually a little indicator that lets you know which way you're facing. The kind of spiral, I guess it's meant to be like an at sign, maybe? It does actually have a little tiny fork on it, so you can actually tell that, like, you're supposed to be facing north here. It's just very subtle. I'd like it if it stood out just a little bit more, or maybe, like, the ground didn't glow as much and the hieroglyph did glow a little bit. And it, like, glowed in such a way that you could even, like, see, like, the little symbol, even if there's, like, a sausage on top of it or something. That would be very nice for reference's sake, but I guess it's okay. Anyway, so there's, as we've seen, there is more than one way to roll a sausage. And there's certainly more than one way to cook it. But its retrievability is definitely a key factor in this game, for sure. It's okay if you can't retrieve a sausage if it's already cooked, but if there's still more work to do with it, you have to be able to get it back from the edge. You can only put it in places where you can keep working with it to a certain extent. Now then. I guess the name of this is also a hint that, like, this is supposed to be a hard puzzle, too. I didn't really, like, think about that. But maybe I should have heeded that warning. That's already a problem. Why didn't I notice that earlier? Yeah, so this is not an issue. This is retrievable. Well, I mean, it would be except for the fact that that burns it. But aside from that, it would be retrievable. Hold on. Oh, you can undo a restart in this game. Okay, that's cool. That's a feature that people have been asking for in other games, and I'm glad to see it actually does show up here. I usually tend to really mean it when I restart. I don't tend to restart on accident. I usually try and explore the full reaches of what I can do, even if it feels like I've lost before I restart, but I think people have pointed out to me in the past, I think in a couple times I have actually restarted when I've been like 3 or 4 moves away from solving a puzzle. Although, obviously, can't really remember when that's happened, but in any case, in cases like those, if I can catch it fast enough, if I think that I was in a good position before, I can undo past a restart and back into a position if I want to. So for example, this is the kind of thing I can do. At least with the vertical one. The vertical one might actually be the easiest one to work with here. Maybe. But retrievability is still an issue. Okay, so with that in mind, now that I know that that's fine, why don't we start with this then? That might give me just enough room to maneuver. I don't know, that's still a bit iffy though. But now I can do that. Yeah, I think that's actually the key. Yeah, that's it, because now I can shove that over. And I think that's going to make a world of a difference. The question is, now what, of course? Well, if I shove this over this way, then that's fully cooked. And that's all well and good. And now I can, for example, cook a sausage like this. The issue is, now that is in the way. So what that suggests to me is that the way of fixing that would be to, at some point, one of these horizontal sausages, I should cook the left and right halves independently. Problem is, I don't know how I would do that with the way that this island is shaped. Well, that isn't fully cooked. What did I do? What did I do wrong? I didn't push it horizontally when the top half was on the grill. When was that? Because I shoved this north too quickly. It was way back at the start. Yeah, that's right. I did not move this horizontally yet. Okay, well, how about I move it horizontally first? Does that solve my problem? It solves my problem only to the extent that, like, now I have to do this. Which isn't immediately an issue. Well, In fact, I have enough room now that now I can do something like this. Get that off the grill and then shove it into a likely-seeming storage spot. In fact, that likely-seeming storage spot is going to be off the left end of the island, I think. Or is it? No, because now that's not good. Or... because now I can push that over there. If this weren't in the way, then I would be set. But it's still bad that it's in the corner. I thought maybe it wouldn't be. That, like, it would be fine. But I think it might actually not be fine. Well, hold up. I can push that way. But that's not going to do anything good, because now there's nowhere it can go except left again, and that's a problem. So it's interesting how these grills are kind of... they're almost acting like trap doors, like one-time use place for sausages in certain positions, but the state information is stored in the sausage, not in the grill. The grill is just a constant factor. So that's neat. But yeah, the fact that these... like, certainly this center... the center position is annoying. By design, I'm sure, but certainly pretty tough. If I didn't already have a sausage in the way, then this would be fine. No, wait, no, it wouldn't. That wouldn't be fine at all. I have to move that off horizontally before, I have to be able to get to the upper side of it and then turn it. I have to be able to make that move and get it off before I can, do this. Okay. Let's back up a little bit to a likely seeming spot where I haven't gone too wrong yet. Before I got that trapped in the upper left-hand corner. Let's even go back before I did that. So I could fry it now. I could do this before I do the other parts. But that makes it impossible to get the top part off unless I do it before I push that there. And I don't want to push that to the side. At least not yet. Yeah, when I... I'd like to be... I think this might be it. Or something similar to this might be it. Let's shove this... I can even push it one more square over, which I think is enough. I can still move that back and forth as much as I want. But the important thing is, now that I've shoved that over to that side... now I've got a better place I can shove this sausage over. Now I can stash it down here. Now it'll be well out of the way. Now I think I can do the rest successfully. Whoops. So now I cook that part. Now I leave this down here. And I should be able to cook the top sausage. Yeah, there we go. Again. It's all about those intermediate steps. Sometimes they're really critical, especially in these pushing puzzles. Just, getting things in really convenient positions for you, just so that you maintain freedom of movement. And, just, you know, leaving this sausage in a nice convenient spot for me, just out of the way. Mmm. Three well-deserved sausages. Look, I'm not even gonna ask what kind of meat is in the sausages. That's just rude. You know, you can do that at a deli, but you don't ask your friend that. You know. You just gotta take him at his word. Just understand that it's good sausage. No matter what kind of sausage it is. Alright, so three sausages were well defeated, but now we must conquer a single sausage. With very, very little maneuverability, unlike the previous puzzle where we had not a whole lot more maneuverability, but at least we had, like, some amount of, like, 2x2 squares of space we could work with. This one is definitely all about cramped quarters, for sure. Instead of just doing things randomly, let's actually form a plan of attack. Because, as I suspected, I don't think either the brute force or the just drunken squirrel method, to borrow Pearls's turn of phrase, are going to be of much use here. So that seems to be the start. We need both halves of the sausage to pass over this grill. I guess I'll just call this... Well, I don't even want to call them side A and side B. I kind of wish that these were textured a little bit so that you could tell, like, which side used to be the top side, which side used to be the bottom side. Like, I almost wish that, like, one half of it were red and one of them were blue, so that when you turned it over, like, they'd swap places. And then you could talk about the red half and the blue half, when, like, just trying to explain a puzzle. And maybe that would be nice as, like a puzzle mode option, just like a toggle that you could turn on and off, because, again, clearly these are just sausages. They're meant to be very homogeneous, and that's by design. But it would be nice to have just, like, these extra quality of life features just for moving them around, I suppose. So... Now, it's okay if we... To a certain extent if we do this. Because, like, for example... ignoring that this is not a problem. Ignoring that this has happened, we can shove this all the way up and dodge around this move. We can push it up and then do that, and that would cook both halves of that. I think I was missing that earlier. So if we can figure out how not to burn that part of the sausage. Again, like, I would love to be able to talk about that, with a specific name. But in any case, if I can avoid that burn, then I think we've actually got most of the steps we need here. It's just a little more subtle than that. Well, I can cook the top half before I do the bottom half like that, because I can still rescue it from that spot. So I can, for example, do that cook, push it down. I'm gonna need to do this part first, so I'll do this, then push it over, then move it up, then move it over, and we've got a cooked sausage. Alright, order of operations, again. That's just how these things work. Well, cool, I actually got past both of my bottlenecks this episode. That's cool. And now... Well, I was kind of kidding when I said it was going to spawn a sausage, but, you know, we got a sausage instead of a bridge. So, there's our bridge. We're going to step across a bridge of raw meat, but desperate times call for desperate measures. Cool, world one done, I guess. And, with no further fanfare, let us move on to harder puzzles. Oh, this is a big level. Got sausage way out there. Like, real way over here. And this might be our first appearance of walls. Yeah, in main puzzle mode. Previous puzzles did not have any walls in them. Yeah, that's right. It was just water, just open ocean, and floor, and grills. No walls. Now we've got walls to deal with. Okay. Well, they could either help or hurt us, but probably mostly hurt us. Let's be real here. Oh yeah, and trees. As we all know, trees are just a special kind of wall. That they're just specialized. In any case, this is probably a good tutorial level, just to get used to walls. Well, that's no good. Right? Yeah, that ain't gonna be no good for nobody. Okay. Maybe we need to go somewhere else, then. In this level, that is. In fact, walls even just make, like, moving around a little bit of a headache sometimes, as we've seen in the overworld. Okay, so how are we gonna get it off this island? I think there's nothing special about the tree, other than just, like, it's just... I guess other than the fact that it's tall. But I don't think it's inherently any different from a wall. But it doesn't seem like I can get it through there. And while I can push it up here, all my remaining moves will go over that way. So everything that moves it to the east would seem to have to go through the space that the tree is taking up. Are there any other resources I have in this level? What's over here? Just a wall. Just a wall. No other sausages down here, just the grill, as I suspected. Yeah, there's a lot of mysterious stuff going on here at the moment. But we'll figure it out. That's what we're here for. So let's review our full range of moves. We have rotating moves, which can turn into pushing moves, like so. That's a move we can make. We can also shove things with our body, like so. We can do upwards turns like that. That's a rolling move, a pushing move, so to say. And there's shoves like that and like that. So this is really just about mastering my movement. I haven't quite got that figured out yet. But appearances would seem to indicate that I don't want the sausage to go into this little square here. Because I don't think I can really work with it after that. So there must be somewhere else I can put it. Can I knock over a tree with a sausage? This is an important question to answer. Aha! Now we're talking. Yeah. Don't seem to be able to turn, though. It's a very heavy sausage. But finally, our fork is actually useful for something. And no, I can't even rotate like this. Can't move upwards to force a rotation by 90 degrees like that. I've played a few games where that was the case, but no such luck. So now we know what walls are for. Can we perhaps grab a more opportune segment of sausage with our fork, which is very much what the fork isn't meant to be. Now, interestingly enough, I think, like, yeah, this specifically happens when you can't push at something. Like, I think we had an earlier level, again, I would love to be able to test this, where, like, doing a stabby motion like this when there was just a bunch of sausages that could roll forward, it just pushed all the sausages forward instead of stabbing one. Because there was a legal move. They could all be pushed forward. And so that did not... Like, there was no stabbing. Well. Now it's all just a matter of figuring out a good stab. You can't stab by turning. That's good to know. Like, I can just immediately rule that out. We can't rotate a sausage from horizontal to vertical yet. We don't seem to have the technology for that yet. This is not even walkable. It's potentially a place where I could pull the fork out of the sausage, though. That'll be interesting. That's some interesting vocabulary there I'm sure we'll get to explore soon. So I guess we'll start with this. This seems to be the only style of stab, there's a sentence for you, that doesn't lead to immediate disaster. So you can yank our fork out of the sausage, as I suspected. And now we are not, now we're not stabbed in there anymore, but we don't have enough, Oh, no, wait, we're fine. I can still get that back. Okay, so what... How's that gonna get us where we need to go? Well... Yeah, the nice thing about a stab, though, is, for example, if I do this, which I will get into position for, now I can hold the sausage over, over water, and move it over water that way. Because, again, we are very strong. So, for example, I could move it over here. I don't know how much that helps, but, I mean, that is something I notice, is that, like, again, it's a horizontal sausage. How else are we going to make progress? That won't help, though. Yeah. So, that was probably a bad place to deposit that. But, it's just an example of the kind of thinking that we're going to need to be able to do here. Can yank that back out. We should be able to do that as many times as we want without damaging it in any way, shape, or form. Hold up. Yeah, okay, actually that's good. Yeah, this is what I was missing. That's critical. Now can I push it one more time? Aha! Yeah, there we go. So the partial, turn succeeded. It didn't fully turn all the way over to the right because of the wall, but the partial, like, that move did actually work. Aha! This is where some of that English country tune experience is going to come into play. Yeah, now we're going places. Now we're going to tour the world, see the sights. Okay, now what do I want to do? Well, we could stab it, maybe. How are we gonna get past all of that, though? Because I'll tell you... Yeah, how is this gonna work? I feel like... I think facing upwards and having an upward stab is actually what I want. Yeah, and I think to do that, I'm gonna have to go back over here. Okay, yeah. That should be okay. Yeah, because I'll go over here. And what I want is to put it over here and stab it like so. So now we're this shape. And we can carry this shape past our obstacle. And now I just need to disengage from the sausage. Turn it over here, and the actual cooking process is very easy. Alright. That's our tutorial, folks. Right, but we need to actually, go to the designated sausage-eating location, though. Still. You know, sometimes hard work just makes your food taste even better. No other puzzles down here, though. I'm keeping my eye on you, raw sausage. We'll be back for it later, I'm sure. I think we got time for one more. That was a bit of a long one, but, oh dear. Well, we got fences now. Fences seem to be the same as walls. At least so far. So now, instead of a horizontal sausage we're gonna be stabbing, we're gonna be working with a vertical sausage, which is... kind of similar. Okay. How do we work this? Well, this seems to be step one. I think I want to go along the bottom, not the top. Thankfully, we got enough room in these hallways to actually move through them. And I yank out, yank on out. I wish I could see if, stepping onto a grill counted for unstabbing. It probably does. If I had to guess, that's probably a legal move that would, unsheath my, fork from the, sausage. Okay, that's interesting. I don't actually seem to be able to get onto this square to turn around. Because I was thinking I would go up here, turn around. I want to be facing south at this part. Well, why don't I... Why do I not do it like this, then? Yeah, there we go. So now I can stab. Oh, right. I'm not going to be rolling it while it's stabbed, now am I? No, of course not. Okay. Well, can I shove it downwards and roll it? Will rolling it... I don't know if rolling it is going to hit the other side yet. I didn't crunch the numbers yet. Yes, there we go. That's how we do both sides of that. In fact, I might not have even needed to do the stab part, but whatever. It looked cool. Now it's easily accessible. Now I can actually get the sausage back without burning myself. Cool. We can do one more, I think. Then we'll probably call it. Yeah, stabbing is going to be very important here because, without stabbing, there's going to be no way to cook both sides of a sausage. There's just no way. Because that side is always going to be the side of the sausage that is facing the grill. But stabbing will allow us to break that, that rule. Question is how we're going to do it with this limited amount of space, but I'm sure we'll figure something out. Oh, so far, well, hold on. We're not going to be able to make a stabby motion after that, but... actually, yeah, how are we going to stab anything here? Well, if I put a sausage on this side... I think this means I'll stab the first one, because even if I burn myself here, which should be okay. Yeah, there we go. Now I just need to figure out how to unstab it. Which is also a good question. Oh, right, I need to not stab the top part of it, I'll stab the bottom part. But I think that's really the only technique I needed to figure out here. I think the rest should just be implementation. But yeah, of course, even if you're holding a sausage over the grill, it'll still cook, of course. Now, if I wanted to get fancy, I might even do something like this. That would work. In fact, I think even this would work, which is interesting to think about. And I should be able to rescue that, yeah. Okay, so I already got part of this, or no, I don't think I ever actually cooked any part of that sausage. I should, yeah, that would be a good idea. And then I should be able to roll it over later and do the other part. Alright, now I just need to get my sausages to switch places. Thankfully, the, just this tactical stuff of just moving the sausages around doesn't seem like it's that hard this time. Got plenty of room. Yeah, so now if I roll this over, no, that's actually not right. I think I must have cooked the same part of it that was going to get cooked anyway. Alright, so that seems to imply that I should just pre-cook these halves then. That way I'll know immediately if I'm holding the right part or not. In fact, actually, that just immediately suggests to me a simpler way of doing this. Right. So we'll do that. Stab that, immediately step back, but now we've got a full sausage. Unhook. We can put that on. It's all fine. Put this into the new position. We'll roll that over, but now we'll be able to stab it and put it back on. And we do need to be able to actually let go of it because the final position has us facing southward. Although I do wonder, of course, now, if you can finish a level while having your fork in a sausage that you then subsequently eat. I'm sure another level will answer that question for us. Alright. So, World 1 was about movement, and World 2 was more about the fork, I suppose. Alright. That's probably enough for now. We'll see what that plinth over there says later. And, further explore our own capabilities.